When was the last time you heard about a Falcon Heavy launch? Well, there's one coming up soon that promises to be unlike any other, so wait and see. The Falcon Heavy, like the Starship, is a giant in the space arena. However, while rockets like the Falcon 9 launch at least 50 times a year into deep space, they don't garner the same level of media attention as the Falcon Heavy for a variety of reasons. One of these is that Falcon Heavy is a rocket to be reckoned within the space and rockets industry. Why is this so? The answer can be found in the rocket's strength, style, and the name of the company that built it. Elon Musk founded SpaceX, which is proudly led by him. As of right now, Elon Musk is the second richest person in the world, according to the Bloomberg Billionaire Index. Falcon Heavy is a product of SpaceX. But that isn't as important as how this tech enthusiast has completely revolutionized every industry he touches. The rocket industry is a good example, and the Falcon Heavy is just one of his brilliant products. For about 3 years in a row, Falcon Heavy has held the title of most powerful rocket. According to SpaceX, the Falcon Heavy can now produce 5 million pounds of thrust, which is equivalent to only 18,747 jumbo jets. Given the admirable thrust of this powerful rocket, it has earned a reputation for putting on a spectacular show at various stages when returning to Earth. However, the SLS is not as good at putting on a spectacular show as the Falcon Heavy, but it has managed to provide a more powerful thrust than the Falcon Heavy. With SLS at 8 million pounds of thrust, we must say that the SOS has come a long way. You see, about a decade ago, the current Starship and Falcon Heavy were just concepts. SLS was already there in a few years of making. The Falcon Heavy, the raw rocket, came from its manufacturers, and took the lead in the most powerful rockets list. This seemingly impressive ability of the Falcon Heavy made NASA a frequent visitor and an unwavering partner to SpaceX for the sake of some delicate missions. We hope you were not thinking that the Falcon Heavy had made over 100 trips to space, because this is not the case. The Falcon Heavy has only made 5 launches since its inception, but this small number should not deceive you, as the rocket's one-time trip can be compared to even 10 trips of another smaller rocket. In a literal sense, this is because the Falcon Heavy is simply a combination of 3 Falcon 9 rockets, and it is the first rocket in SpaceX history to transport the Tesla Roadster to space. The sports car is still making many oblong trips around the sun in the barren vacuum. But SpaceX has laid out an interesting plan to make 2023 memorable for its Falcon Heavy rocket. The SpaceCom company mentioned planning 5 launches for the Falcon Heavy rocket just this year, and the seemingly ambitious plan appears to be rolling out perfectly since the Falcon Heavy's first launch was a success. A thorough examination of what occurred during the maiden Falcon Heavy flight is sufficient to predict that the subsequent and subsequent launches will be memorable. The Falcon Heavy's first launch since the beginning of the year was attached to one mission transporting the U.S. Space Force's USSF-67 mission to geostationary Earth orbit. This was the Falcon Heavy's second national security space launch mission. Something unique about this first launch is that it will reuse the same side boosters from the USSF-44 mission. Remember USSF-44? It's the mission whose minute details remain scanty at best. Something about carrying tools for the U.S. Department of Defense was muttered, but the rest of the details have remained a mystery to this day. Well, for the USSF-67 mission, things were a little clearer and even more exciting on the set launch day for the USSF-67. The weather wasn't favorable, with winds raging over 20 miles per hour across the Kennedy Space Center launch. So the mission had to be pushed ahead one day, but even with the one-day late mission, when the skies cleared, the Falcon Heavy engine roared, releasing the much-anticipated 5.1 million pounds of thrust that sent it across the space center. The cheers of the excited SpaceX employees and their families were drowned out as the rumble of Falcon Heavy's engines roared, displaying its power across the sky. We had another amazing launch in few days on a Falcon Heavy. The stunning whiff from the Space Systems Command confirmed that the mission was a success, he added, while there would still be threats to the Department of Defense and National Security space launch, Falcon Heavy will still be viable for more space excursions, according to an estimate, and SpaceX will be given more contracts from the NSSL between 2024 and 2027. While price is a secondary consideration, Pentecost was clearly proud that the introduction of competition into national security launches has lowered prices. This can be traced to SpaceX's entry into the program in 2015, and particularly to the debut of the company's Falcon Heavy rocket in 2018. We've saved almost 50% over what the older prices were like for the Delta Heavy, Pentecost said. The Vulcan and the Falcon Heavy are about half the cost of what a Delta Heavy used to cost, in order to put the National Reconnaissance Office's biggest satellites into space. So we are saving a ton of money on the high end, while we're still managing to utilize the commercial prices on the low end. The military hopes that by opening Lane 1, it will be able to nurture still more competitors for high-value missions later in the 2030s. And it appears that the newer U.S. launch companies all have such aspirations. As we talk to the Rocket Labs, Relativities, the ABLs, they all talk about how they're expanding from their smaller launch focus into medium lift, Pentecost said. And everybody has plans to go even higher. Balancing range demand. One sign of the emergence of new competitors, as well as SpaceX and potentially United Launch Alliance ramping up their launch frequency, is the usage of the Eastern and Western ranges, operated by the U.S. Space Force. The Eastern Range encompasses Cape Canaveral and Kennedy Space Center, in Florida, as well as Wallops Flight Facility in Virginia. The Western Range includes Vandenberg Space Force Base, and other U.S. launch sites in the Pacific. Pentecost shared the following data about increasing launch cadence at both ranges, as well as a projection for this year. One of the reasons why they selected SpaceX is because they placed the Europa Clipper in Category 3 for launch services. This means that the Europa Clippers should be carried on a commercial vehicle that has performed at least three successful launches. This put the Falcon Heavy miles above competing commercial rockets. You see, SpaceX's Falcon Heavy was successfully flown three times, despite not being launched since 2019. Other competing vehicles such as United Launch Alliance's Vulcan Centaur and Blue Origin's New Glenn haven't even had their first launches. Yet the Falcon Heavy is also more efficient in terms of payload delivery. Compared to the other rockets, the Falcon Heavy is able to deliver 63,800 kilograms to Earth's lower orbit. While the Vulcan Centaur can deliver 27,200 kilograms and lastly, the New Glenn can deliver 14,000 kilograms and in terms of cost per launch. The New Glenn would reportedly cost NASA about $2 billion to launch with them and the Vulcan Centaur would cost them about $200 million. So it's a no-brainer why NASA went with SpaceX. It's cheaper, more proven, and far more efficient. The only issue with selecting the Falcon Heavy is that it's slightly slower than NASA's SLS. With the SLS, the Europa Clipper would have arrived at Jupiter's moon in less than 3 years, but with Falcon Heavy, it should arrive at Europa in about 5.5 years after it launches. Lately, the United States government has been putting a lot of faith in SpaceX. The Europa Clipper contract is one of several future Falcon Heavy missions with NASA. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.